8 quizzes are about to go head-to-head in the ultimate knockout competition, where favourites can be overthrown and underdogs can end up top dog. Let the games begin. Hello, I'm Alex Scott and welcome to the tournament. A knockout game where general knowledge, quick thinking and staying calm under pressure are vital if you want to win. Let's meet today's players.
I'm Kelly from Nottinghamshire. I'm a lecturer in nutrition and for me, nothing is as sweet as the taste of victory.
I'm Patrick, I'm a teacher from Suffolk and it's time to deliver my next lesson, a lesson in winning in style.
I'm Martha from Surrey. I'm currently on maternity leave. I might be sleep deprived, but no worries. I can beat the competition with my eyes closed.
I'm Lawrence from Belfast. I'm a tennis player and I'm going to ace this quiz to become champion.
I'm Dahlia from Manchester. I have a master's degree in psychology, so I'll be good at sussing out my opponents before I beat them on the run.
I'm Craig from Lincolnshire. I'm a balloon modeller and I'm so happy to be on the tournament, I might just pop.
I'm Jennifer from Guildford. I love travelling and I'm planning on spending my tournament winnings on a first-class trip around the world.
I'm John from Perth. I'm a taxi driver and I'm planning on taking the quickest route to my final destination, the Golden Run.
Welcome, everyone, and all of you are gunning for victory, but of course, there can only be one winner today, and who will it be? We're about to find out. And Dahlia, I'm coming straight to you. Psychology.
Mm-hmm.
So you are reading the room right now?
I've been sussing out everyone a little bit, so
really?
I'm ready to go.
Oh, well, tell me more.
I have a good understanding of people's sort of strengths and weaknesses at the moment, so hopefully that should come into use.
Oh, OK, so you are one to watch. And on your shoulder, then, is Lawrence going to be one to watch?
Definitely. He's definitely got his strengths, for sure.
Lawrence, what are those strengths?
I don't know, probably a bit of sports. I play tennis. I'm a trampoline coach, so I really get into my sports.
Oh.
Very competitive.
We'll see if you've given some of your game away. Let me come to Martha. New mum.
Well, third time mum, but okay. yeah, recent addition to the family.
Well, how's the baby brain?
I mean, that's why I'm here. I applied for this at 4 a.m. In the very early weeks of her life, so I'm hoping it'll hold up all right today.
OK, well, it's time to get cracking. And first up, though, we need to create our leaderboard. So I'm going to be asking 8 questions. The smartest and fastest will find themselves in pole position, which means banking the most cash and having the power to choose who you take on and take out in the knockout matches. Is everyone ready?
Yes!
Yes! OK, let's play. Question 1. Entomology is the scientific study of what? Insects, birds, reptiles, fish. All locked in, and the answer is insects. All in the green! Just what I like. You're matching me. Love it. OK. Question 2. Which of these actresses played matron in Carry On Nurse? Angela Lansbury, Thora Heard, Hattie Jakes, Joanna Lumley. All locked in? And the answer is Hattie Jakes. Lawrence, no?
No.
OK, we've got a long way to go yet. Question 3. Which of these countries sits on the equator? Argentina, China, Kenya, Australia. All locked in, and the answer is Kenya. Jennifer, our traveller. Lucky you got that one right. Question 4. Including the white, how many balls are on a snooker table at the start of a game? 14, 16, 22, 27. All locked in? The answer is 22. Just two right. Competition heating right up. Question 5. Which of these words was the Oxford English Dictionary Word of the Year for 2021? NFT, Benifer, Vax, Doom Scrolling. All locked in, and the answer is facts. A lot of reds, but we have some greens. Kelly, you're back in the game over there. Question six. Approximately, how long does it take light from the sun to reach Earth? 8 seconds, 8 minutes, 8 hours, 8 days. All locked in, and the answer is 8 minutes. Patrick, our teacher. No?
I thought it was quicker than that.
Lawrence, you're doing well.
Hopefully that's catching up.
Well, you are starting to ace it. Question seven. The National Health Service was started in which year? 1938, 1958, 1968, 1948. All locked in, and the answer is 1948. There we are, more in the green. It's what I like to see. Last question, question eight. Hampden Park is the home of which national men's and women's football team? Northern Ireland, England, Scotland, Wales. All locked in? And the answer is Scotland. Ooh, back of the net for six of you. I like it. We've scored some goals, but we've got two own goals right in front of me. OK, that is all the questions complete. It's time to find out how everyone has done. So at the bottom, with a crisp tenner, is Dahlia, with three correct answers. Craig is in seventh, then we have a run of five correct answers. Kelly, John and Martha, the fastest of the fives. Then we have a run of six correct answers. Jennifer in third, Lawrence in second, which means that at top of the table, looking surprised, it's Patrick with a tasty looking grand. Patrick!
Oh, wow.
Why are you surprised? Top of the class.
I got some wrong. I've had a couple of stinkers.
Okay, well, you've got a gold star from me at this moment in time, Patrick. Okay, well, we have our rankings and we know who's top. And now we start our head-to-head matches on the tournament run in the ultimate quiz and tug of war. All the matches last up to 2 minutes. Each correct answer pushes your opponent a step back towards the red knockout zone. Whoever pushes their opponent closest to the red zone is the winner, and they will steal their opponent's money and qualify for the next round. The loser is eliminated. If you do push your opponent all the way into the red, just like the yellow is doing right now, you get a knockout, which means you have bragging rights and a cheeky £500 bonus. OK, Patrick, people now have their eye on you, but who are you looking to take out?
I didn't go for the obvious because I don't think a low score means poor. Okay. So I've gone for a little bit higher up the board and I've gone for Martha.
Martha on your shoulder right there. Martha is locked in. Martha, he wants your £400. You're not going to give it up easy, though, are you?
No, I'm definitely going to fight for it.
Yes. You said about your 4 a.m, wide awake, wanting to be here.
Yep, yep. And if I win, then hopefully I can use that £400 to go online shopping at 4 a.m. rather than do my things like a bunch of quiz shows.
OK, well, Patrick, you get to decide what category. You've got film and TV, music, places, science and tech, sports and games, food and drink, or natural world?
Sports and games.
Sports and games it is. Play any kind of sports?
It's been a while. I just swim and cycle now for fun.
Swim and cycle?
Aye.
OK. Martha, do you have the stamina to see this one through?
I'll give it a good go.
You like your sports?
Enough, I think.
OK, we're about to find out. It's time for kickoff. It's Patrick v Martha in the category sports and games. Patrick, you've got a stare-off going on there. Feels like you're in a sprinting stance, ready to go as well.
I did used to athletics.
Martha, you feeling OK?
I reckon so, yeah. We'll give it a go.
Well, before we do start, let's take a look at who the favourite is. And all our players faced a pre-tournament test of their general knowledge. And based on their scores, I can reveal that the favourite for this head-to-head in sports and games is... Martha.
OK.
There's a turn up for the books. Martha, you OK being the favourite?
I wasn't expecting it, but, you know, we'll go with it.
No pressure.
Patrick, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Martha, are you ready?
I'm ready.
You have 2 minutes on the clock, starting in... Which sport is the subject of the video game FIFA 22? Martha.
Football.
Correct. In which European country is the Formula One circuit of Monza? Patrick?
Italy.
Correct. In cricket, what O is a set of 6 consecutive legal bowls? Martha.
Over.
Correct. The outdoor team game of hurling is a national sport of which EU country? Out of time, Ireland. In a standard British pack of playing cards, the 4 suits are hearts, clubs, diamonds and... Patrick.
Spades.
Correct. What is the full name of the tabletop game often called D&D? Martha.
Dungeons and Dragons.
Correct. Who is the all-time top scorer in the Liga? Patrick.
Messi.
Correct. Basketball player Michael Jordan won 6 NBA championships. Patrick.
Chicago Bulls.
Correct. In what year did London host both the Summer Olympic and the... Martha?
2012.
Correct. Bobby Fischer and Garry Kasparov. Patrick.
Chess.
Correct. Which British tennis player became the first qualifier in the Open era to win a Grand Slam tournament? Patrick.
Andy Murray.
Incorrect. Throw over.
Emma Raducanu.
Correct. What is the highest scoring hand in the card game poker? Patrick.
Royal Flush.
Correct. In video games, what primary colour is Sonic the Hedgehog? Martha.
Blue.
Correct. In the popular online game Wordle, how many letters appear in each word that a player... Martha.
6.
Incorrect. Throw over. Must guess.
5.
Correct. In golf, what... And that is a win for Patrick!
Well done.
Patrick, wow, just in time there. The underdog, you weren't the favourite going into it, you picked the
category. I know, I nearly bit off more than I can chew.
What really a good. Game.
You're really good.
Martha.
So close, so close.
You're really good.
Play Wordle. Oh, yeah, my downfall.
That online shopping now.
I know, it will just have to come out of a credit card and I'll hope for the best.
Well, Martha, thank you for being on the tournament. We will see you in the next episode. Thank you very much. But congratulations, Patrick. You have just stolen Martha's £400, giving you a grand total right now, £1,400. Off to a great start. We'll see you in the next round.
Thank you.
OK, it's time for our next head-to-head. And, Lawrence, you are second on that leaderboard. You just saw Patrick ace his way into the next round. Who else looks like a strong opponent that you want to take out?
So I think I'm going to go for Jennifer.
Jennifer, you are locked in right there. So you're taking a risk, why?
Yeah, going for the money.
Going for the money. You like the big cash prize.
Definitely.
OK, Jennifer, he's locked you in.
I was trying not to catch his eye.
All right.
There's nowhere to hide in this game, Jennifer.
Oh, dear.
Well, you need to decide the category. So you have film and TV, music, places, science and tech, food and drink, natural world.
Well, I know which one I have to avoid against Jennifer, so I'm going to go for science and tech.
Science and tech it is. Smart choice there. Jennifer?
Well, I think every category is a gift.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll just embrace it.
Like that. Just embrace it. Fearless. That's what we love. It's time for kickoff. It's Lawrence v. Jennifer in the category science and tech. So we know you like tennis, Lawrence. How good are you?
I think I like tennis, but I wouldn't say I'm necessarily great at it.
OK, well, hopefully your quizzing's better then.
Hopefully.
But before we do start, we need to find out who the favourite is in the category science and tech. And I can reveal it is... Lawrence.
Wasn't expecting that.
You picked the category, Lawrence.
I know, I just thought Jennifer was such a strong opponent. I was worried.
Lawrence, are you ready?
Yeah.
Jennifer, are you ready?
I'm ready.
You have 2 minutes starting in. In the solar system, which planet is situated between Mars and Saturn? Lawrence?
Jupiter.
Correct. Which image editing program beginning with P was first? Lawrence?
Photoshop.
Correct. Which chemical element has the symbol Fe? Lawrence?
Iron.
Correct. Which electrical household appliance can be described as four slice and pop up? Jennifer?
Toaster.
Correct. What does the W stand for in the name of the industrial lubricant WD-40? Lawrence?
Wire.
Incorrect, throw over.
Wet.
Incorrect, water. On March 21st, 2006, Jack Dorsey sent the first ever message, Jennifer.
Twitter.
Correct. In current British electrical wiring, what colour wire is attached to the live terminal in a 3-pin plug? Jennifer.
Brown.
Correct. In geometry, how many degrees are there in a quarter of a circle? Lawrence.
90.
Correct. In computing, RAM stands for random access what? Lawrence.
Memory.
Correct. iPlayer is the video on demand service of which UK... Lawrence?
BBC.
Correct. What M is a type of radiation that falls between infrared and radio waves on... Lawrence?
Micro. Microwave.
Correct. In medicine, which sight organ of the human body is affected by the condition known as myopia? Lawrence?
Eyes.
Correct. Which word is a combination of picture and element and describes a small dot on a screen? Lawrence?
Pixel.
Correct, and it's a win for Lawrence!
Well,
woo! Lawrence, you are fast on that buzzer.
You need to be.
You were just too fast for me.
He sure was, Jennifer. It was a tight match at the beginning, though.
I know. I kept trying to get in there and I just couldn't. He was just in there before me.
Oh, Jennifer. Well, we do have to say goodbye, but we will see you in the next episode.
Excellent.
Oh, well, Lawrence, a huge congratulations.
Thanks.
You've stolen Jennifer's £600, giving you a nice grand total of £1,350. You're also off to a great start. We'll see you in the next round. Well done. Okay, John, you are next highest on the leaderboard. Our taxi driver.
Indeed, yes.
Looking to take the quickest route, not just to the final, to the golden run.
Although at the moment it seems like I've got stuck in the middle of the road.
Well, you've gone into some traffic at the moment. Yeah. Looking around, who are you looking to take on?
I think I will go for Craig.
Oof, Craig is locked in. Why, a battle of the shirts going on here?
Pretty much. Or... it's competition for best dressed man. We must get rid of him.
Craig likes the shirt.
I don't know. I mean, he doesn't like the money, obviously.
Or we could be thinking an easy route. He said he wants to get the golden run.
You know, I might just look the fool.
Oh, I'm sure you're not going to be, Craig. We are about to find out. Categories left to pick, John. Film and TV, music, places, food and drink, natural world.
I think I will go for music.
Music it is. What type of music are you into?
I kind of stopped being down with the kids about 2010, so if we could keep it as early as possible, that would be great.
OK. Do you play any instruments?
Well, I impulse bought an accordion recently.
Oh.
And I've just started lessons. I would hesitate to say that I actually play it, though. I just make a noise.
Well, everyone loves a tryer, John. Everyone loves a tryer. Craig?
I can play the flute.
The flute?
I learned at school to impress a girl.
And how did that go?
Well, I didn't marry her, but, you know.
Was she not impressed then?
No.
Well, hopefully you can press us in this round because it is time for kickoff. It's John V. Craig in the category music. It is time to find out who the favourite in the category music is, and I can reveal it is... John, it's you. John, are you ready?
As I'll ever be.
Craig, are you ready?
I'm ready.
You have 2 minutes on the clock, starting in... Which city is calling in the title of John?
London.
Correct. Which US artist had her fourth number one UK hit single with La Isla Bonita? John?
Oh, Jenny Halliwell.
Incorrect. Throw over.
Mel C.
Incorrect. Madonna. In what decade did the first Eurovision Song Contest, John?
60s.
Incorrect. Throw over. Take place.
70s.
Incorrect. 1950s. Which rock band opened the 1985 Wembley Live Aid concert with the song Rockin' All Over, Craig?
Bee Gees.
Incorrect. Throw over.
Status Quo.
Correct. Which band had their first UK number one hit single with Bohemian Rhapsody? John?
Queen.
Correct. The opera by Rossini, which debuted in 1816, is called The Barber of what? John?
Seville.
Correct. Singers Zara Larsson and Robin are from which Scandinavian? John?
Sweden.
Correct. Which singer, known as the Godfather of Soul, had songs? John?
James Brown.
Correct. In music, an octave is a series of how many, John?
Eight.
Correct. Which 80s pop group was formed by Sarah Dallin, Siobhan Fahey, John?
Bananarama.
Correct. And that, John, is a knockout from you. Woo! Impressive stuff, John.
Thank you.
What, are you taking it in right now?
I'm just trying to unclench everything.
Okay, well, while you doing our look this way, Craig, wow.
I didn't get to stand a chance, did I,
really? He didn't stand a chance. He knew what he was doing. Well, Craig, we do say goodbye, but we will see you on the next episode. Your balloon did just pop. John, I'm looking back your way now. Congratulations. Well, you've just stolen Craig's £50, and you did it with a knockout, so throw in the cheeky £500 bonus on top of that, giving you a grand total right now of £800, and you are through to the semi-final. We will see you there. Okay, it's time for our next head-to-head, and Kelly, you are highest on that leaderboard. You know your opponent. Let's lock Dahlia in right now. OK, Kelly, it's over to you to pick the category. I know you want that victory, but we need to see you through to the semi-final first.
Definitely.
Film and TV, places, food and drink, natural world.
I think I'm going to go food and drink.
Food and drink it is. Like your cooking?
I do like cooking, yeah, and I'm a nutritionist, so I'd like to think I know a little bit.
Dahlia, she's picked a strong subject, one of her favourites.
Not looking good, but I'm going to give it my best shot.
I like that, yes. Still remaining positive right there. OK, it's going to be a good one. It's time for kickoff. It's Kelly v. Dahlia in the category food and drink. We have just seen a knockout. You two could do with a cheeky £500 bonus.
Mm-hmm, definitely could.
<For sure. laughs> Well, Dahlia, you said psychology, mm-hmm. and you can read the room.
Mm-hmm. I knew she'd pick that topic.
Oh,
yeah. I had a feeling.
And body language from Kelly?
She's looking very confident, very open body language, so we'll see how it goes.
Okay.
I enjoy a challenge, so let's go.
Sounds like game on.
Mm-hmm. Game on it is, but we need to see who the favourite is. And I can tell you the favourite in the category food and drink is... Kelly, it's you.
Right, let's see if I can live up to that now.
Kelly, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Dahlia, are you ready?
I was born ready.
You have 2 minutes on the clock, starting in... The fried noodle dish, pad thai, is... Dahlia?
Thailand.
Correct. What colour is the alcoholic drink Aperol? Kelly?
Green.
Incorrect, throw over.
White.
Incorrect, orange. What cut of meat has types called a back and... Dahlia?
A pork.
Incorrect, throw over. And
bacon.
Correct. Beginning with the letter P, what is the key spice in a traditional... Kelly?
Paprika.
Correct. Cherry, plum and beef... Kelly?
Tomato.
Correct. The Stargazy pie originates from which English county in the southwest? Kelly?
Cornwall.
Correct. A Vespa martini was invented as... Dahlia?
Italy.
Incorrect. Throw over as a favourite drink of which fictional British spy?
James Bond.
Correct. The suet pudding that is sometimes known as a dead man's arm is a jam what? Kelly?
Roly-poly.
Correct. An egg which has been fried on only one side can be... Dahlia?
Sunny side up.
Correct. What chocolate bar shares its name with a packed meal eaten outside, often on a blanket? Kelly?
Picnic.
Correct. In restaurants, the abbreviation BYO stands for... Dahlia?
Bring your own beer.
I'll accept. Which famous chef became well known for his campaign against the school meal? Kelly?
Jamie Oliver.
Correct. Which three-letter word can come after brown, ginger or... Kelly?
Spice.
Incorrect. Throw over. India pale to make the names of drinks.
Ale.
Correct. Which fruit is traditionally used in the making of a tart tatin? Dahlia.
Oranges.
Incorrect. Throw over. And that's a win for Kelly.
You're looking down, you're looking around, yeah. You've won.
Thank you very much.
Did it feel very close up there?
Really
that's why you're unsure.
Really awesome. Yeah. Really, really close. Yeah.
Dahlia, you put up a good fight. Mm-hmm. But Kelly was very strong in that round.
Very worthy opponent, so. Oh,
you read her body language, you said she was confident, mm-hmm. and she delivered. Mm-hmm. Okay, we say goodbye for now, but we will see you on the next episode.
Thank you.
Okay, Kelly, congratulations. You've just stolen Dahlia's £10, giving you a grand total of £110, but you are through to the semi-final.
Thank you.
We'll see you there.
Well done, Dahlia.
Okay, now we are at the semi-final stage, so let's take a quick look and see how this tournament is playing out. And as it stands, in fourth is Kelly, in third we have John, in second we have Lawrence, and top of the table, in pole position, right now it's you, Patrick. Feeling good up there?
Kind of.
Kind of. Well, it is still all to play for, and things get very interesting right now. Let's see what game you are about to play. Looking at your competition, who are you going to take on?
Well, I've weighed them up like any teacher would their pupils. And
nice.
They're all pretty good. They're all very strong. Mm-hmm. So I just figured I'd just go for the top and go for Lawrence.
Lawrence is locked in. Lawrence, are you feeling confident?
Yeah, I'm feeling good. Like in the categories left.
OK, I like it, but Patrick, you get to decide the category. Film and TV, places, natural world.
Film and TV.
Film and TV it is. Oh, Lawrence, you're smiling at me.
No.
Nervous smile, then.
No, this would be the one that I would have had down the bottom of the ones I would have liked.
Oh, no, you don't want to tell him that.
Well, he's chosen, not I.
OK, well, this semi-final is going to be very interesting. It's time for kickoff. It's Patrick v Lawrence in the category Film and TV. We've got Lawrence looking for game, set and match right now, but Patrick wants to win in style. This one could be a tasty one. Well, before we do start, let's take a look at who the favourite is in the category Film and TV, and I can reveal that it is... Even Stevens.
Interesting.
It is interesting. Lawrence, were you playing a bit of a game?
No.
Well, it just goes to show, don't underestimate yourself, Lawrence. Patrick, are you ready?
Check.
Lawrence, are you ready?
Yeah.
2 minutes are on the clock and your time starts in. In the Harry Potter film series, which actress plays the character Hermione Lawrence?
Emma Watson.
Correct. The director of the 1964 film Doctor Strange Love, Patrick?
Stanley Kubrick.
Correct. What was the name of the character in Friends who ran the coffee shop for Lawrence?
Gunther.
Correct. Gary Oldman won a Best Actor Oscar for portraying which famous Lawrence?
Winston Churchill.
Correct. Which hit film from the 80s had a 2022 sequel subtitled Maverick? Lawrence?
Top Gun.
Correct. The creator and star of the TV drama I May Destroy You is Michaela who? Out of time, Cole. Which British music TV show featured the dance troupes Pans People and Patrick?
Top of the Pops.
Correct. In which 2022 BBC drama does Jamie Dornan play a man who wakes up in the Australian outback with no memory? Lawrence?
The Stranger.
Incorrect. Throw over.
The Tourist.
Correct. Which Disney film of 2013 features the hit song Let It Go? Lawrence?
Frozen.
Correct. In which US political drama series did Martin Sheen play Lawrence?
West Wing.
Correct. Which Pixar film was the world's first completely computer animated feature film? Lawrence?
Toy Story.
Correct. The Netflix reality series Selling Sunset follows high-end real estate agents working in which US? Lawrence?
California.
Incorrect. Throw over. US city.
Las Vegas.
Incorrect. The answer was Los Angeles. But we have a winner from Lawrence. Oh. You underestimated yourself
but
look.
Yeah.
You've just got through to the final. You've just aced it.
I'm actually really surprised.
Well, I'll let you take it in because you do look surprised. Patrick,
he was just fast on the button. I knew a few of his answers.
Well, you lost this one, but we will see you on the next episode, Patrick. Thank you for being on the tournament.
I'll be back.
And Lawrence, we like it. Lawrence, though, congratulations. I know you're still shocked, but you've just stolen Patrick's £1,400, giving you a nice grand total of £2,750 so far, and you've qualified for the final. We'll see you there.
Well done.
OK, it's time for our second semi-final. And, John, you are higher placed on the leaderboard. We know your opponent, Kelly, is locked in. You said you wanted the quickest route to that golden run. We're not there yet. You haven't hit a speed bump. You've delivered.
She looks like a bit of a roadblock.
Oh.
But we'll see.
What? Kelly, good or a bad thing?
Don't know quite how to take that. I take it in the most positive way.
OK, John, you get to decide the category, places, natural world.
Well, I'm a taxi driver who doesn't know where anything is, so I will go for natural world.
And natural world it is. You like your nature?
I'm partial to a critter. I've sat through a few David Attenboroughs.
OK. Kelly, nodding away. Don't know how to take John over there.
Yeah, David Attenborough is my hero. I mean, literally my hero. I'm not saying I learnt anything, but he is my hero.
OK. It's our second semi-final and it's time for kickoff. It's John v Kelly in the category Natural World. Kelly, you want that sweet taste of victory? Or is John going to leave you with a bitter taste in your mouth, Kelly?
I hope not.
John, you need to stay on course in this one.
That's a plan.
OK, let's find out who the favourite is and I can reveal in the category Natural World, it is... Kelly.
It's a turn up.
For the books. OK, John, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Kelly, are you ready?
Ready.
2 minutes are on the clock and your time starts in. Beginning with the letter I, which liquid does an octopus with... John?
Ink.
Correct. What giant shelled animal did Charles Darwin study in the Galapagos? John?
Turtles.
Incorrect. Throw over.
Tortoise?
Correct. Which flowering plant has types including stargazer and tiger? John?
Lily.
Correct. Beginning with C, what are the smallest blood vessels called? Kelly?
Capillaries.
Correct. Which bird beginning with M is the most common wild duck in the UK? John?
Mallard.
Correct. Recluse, huntsman and... John?
Spider.
Correct. What is the world's fastest land animal? John?
Cheetah.
Correct. The Earth's ozone layer sits in which layer of the atmosphere beginning with S? Kelly?
No, it's gone, sorry.
Throw over.
Sky?
Incorrect. Stratosphere. How many wings does a dragonfly have? Kelly?
Four.
Correct. In a rainbow, what colour appears between orange and green? John?
Yellow.
Correct. Which saint gave his name to the large dogs used to... John?
Bernard.
Correct. A group of which birds can be called a murder? Kelly?
Crows.
Correct. Which flat fish shares its name with the bottom surface of a foot? John?
Sole.
Correct. Which common household pet has the scientific name Felis catus? John?
Cat.
Correct. What shape are the cells in a honeycomb? Kelly?
Hexagon.
Correct. What textile is produced from cocoons spun by caterpillars? John?
Silk.
Correct. And that's a win for John! Ooh! What a semi-final!
Yeah, it was very quick, very quick.
I'm stressed out now, though.
Why are you stressed?
Because she was very good. I thought I was going to get a whopping there.
Well, you delivered. You're still on track. But, Kelly, a great opponent.
Thank you.
Well played.
Very good. Well, we are saying goodbye now, but we will see you in the next episode, Kelly. OK, well, John, a huge congratulations. You've just stolen Kelly's £110, giving you a grand total of £910. And you have qualified for the final, John. Cool. See you there. Okay, this is it. It's the big one. 8 quizzes are now down to just 2. A huge congratulations both to Lawrence and to John. You've made it to the final, but this time you are playing to win your own cash pot. For you, Lawrence, that is a grand total of £2,750. John, for you, that's a grand total of £910. But the loser will be going home empty-handed. Remember, if the winner gets a knockout, they will have the chance to double their money on the golden run. So it is. It's all to play for. And the category is general knowledge. It's time for kickoff in the final of the tournament. It's Lawrence v. John. OK, John, you've spoken about the quickest route to the golden run. You are nearly there, but it will require a knockout. Lawrence, you've not hit a double fault yet. Ace all the way.
Yeah, hopefully.
You've been pretty strong.
Need to get the ace, though, and got to get the knockout.
What would you do with the money, Lawrence?
I'm heading to South America in a couple of months, so I'd love to visit... Actually, I'd want to visit the Galapagos Islands, see the giant tortoises. So that was actually what I wanted to do with the money. I know, sorry.
John, what would you do with the money?
I'd probably spend it all on really cool shirts.
Nice! Yeah. Okay! Well, before the final gets underway, let's see who the favourite is in the category general knowledge. And it is... Lawrence. Well, you've made it this far, yeah. Lawrence. You're doing well. But John is very strong, and look, he's ready to go. Lawrence, are you ready?
Yeah.
John, are you ready?
Yep.
You have 2 minutes on the clock, starting in... What P is a person who attends to and repairs household water supplies? John.
Plumber.
Correct. Which musical features an orphan and her dog? John.
Annie.
Correct. Woman's Hour and The Archers are programmes... John.
Radio 4.
Correct. In Islam, profession of faith, prayer, alms, fasting and pilgrimage are known as the five what? Lawrence.
Hellas.
Correct. What animal is associated with the star sign Leo? Lawrence.
Lion.
Correct. Which French fashion designer is famous for making stiletto? Lawrence.
Louis Vuitton.
Correct. In miles per hour, what is the UK national speed limit? John.
70.
Correct. In Greek mythology, what is the name of the goddess of love and beauty? Lawrence.
Aphrodite.
Correct. What direction does the letter N represent on... Lawrence.
North.
Correct. The traditional bingo call for which number is clickety-click? John.
66.
Correct. What's the 11th letter of the English alphabet? Lawrence.
K.
Correct. In which month is International Women's Day? Lawrence.
January.
Incorrect. Throw over.
April.
Incorrect. March. In employment, what do the letters WFH usually stand for? John.
Work from home.
Correct. Wee Willy Winky is a nursery rhyme originally written in which of the countries of the United Kingdom? John.
Scotland.
Correct. If an American refuses to answer questions in court, they may be... John.
Pleading the fifth.
Correct. Ooh, and that is a win for John.
Good job, good job.
What a final. John, you're taking it in. You're quiet there.
I think it was more luck than skill, to be honest.
Well, luck was on your side today. Lawrence.
He just knew all those answers and he's faster.
Well, we know how fast you are on that buzzer. It was going back and forth, just like a tennis match there, Lawrence.
He won in the end.
It was quite the rally, but he did win in the end. Lawrence, we say goodbye. You've been a great contender, but we're going to see you on the next episode. Well, John.
Hi.
It's time to go shirt shopping.
Indeed.
We're going to change that to a saint because you have been one today. You've just won yourself £910. A huge congratulations, John.
Thank you very
much. Well, can one of our players match that or do even better next time on the tournament? Remember, if you can't outsmart your opponent, it's simple. Just outplay them. See you next time. Goodbye.